Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll talk about linear simulation in Genesys. We'll add an active component, we'll set up a linear simulation, display linear measurements, and I'll show you how to add additional schematics to the workspace and combine schematic elements into one. When you start up Genesys, you should get a blank screen like you see here. If you don't, well, then you can go to the Start News page or File, New, which will generate a new schematic. And so let's go over to the part selector, where I've actually pre-selected one of the transistors from the Agilent library. You can select from a number of different libraries, but here we're going to use an Agilent part. We'll double-click on that, and you see the green text indicating the file name. Let's browse through that and look at the particular parameters. You see there are five files associated with this, actually seven. They all represent different biases and currents. If I select the last one, then that represents 5 volts at 20 milliamps. And we can scroll through the list here to look at the S parameters versus frequency and determine if this device is going to meet our gain requirements and so forth, as well as perhaps our noise requirements here. You see the noise data at the end. I'll press OK to accept, and then OK, and now this model is represented by the one we selected. If we want to suppress the file name, we can do that by unselecting the box. Let's add a couple of ports here. The I for the input port, the O key for output port, and I'll press the G key to get ground. Okay, now we're ready to set up a simulation. We come to the workspace tree, select analysis, then add linear analysis. Notice we have a number of others to select from. We can change the name, which is default is linear 1, or the design in this case is the schematic 1. We can change the dataset name if we want to, or accept the default. We can add a description of our simulation. Here under DC analysis, normally we use default, and that allows DC analysis when we use a nonlinear component. I set the start and stop frequency of our simulation here. We'll start at 500 MHz and stop at 1500 MHz. And then for calculating noise, if this is an active device such as our example here, yeah, we want to calculate noise. Automatic recalculation allows us to automatically run a simulation whenever we tune a component. And here we can set the linear number of points to whatever we wish. 101 is default. We can also set log points per decade as the way to simulate. Linear number of step sizes, in this case it's 1 megahertz. We can change that to terahertz, gigahertz, or whatever we wish, and change the step size. We can also generate a list of frequencies, and only those frequencies that are shown here as we type in 500, 600, and 700 will be used for the simulation. So we'll take the default of 101. These advanced options that you see here for G-min and preferred reduction size, those are advanced features. I would direct your attention to help in order to get more information on that, but generally you won't have to reset those. This temperature is the temperature we're going to use for our noise calculation. Okay, so we're about ready to go. As a matter of fact, we just did the simulation. It was that quick. Let me right-click on the output port, and we're going to generate a graph of S21, or gain. And here you see a gain from 22 to around 12 dB across that band. We'll now tile the windows here so we can get a better view of the two. Let me add another measurement. In this case, we're going to measure S11. You notice how quick and easy it is to make these measurements. Now notice here I've selected Smith chart in order to generate a graph. But let's look also at S22 because we like to see both of them simultaneously displayed. And I'll select from one of the many measurements that are available. We're going to look at S22 in this case. And both are displayed here. And when I press OK, you'll see a Smith chart, of course, with both measurements displayed. And let's tile the windows again. Now, one other measurement we might be interested in, especially for an active device, is something like a noise figure. So I'll come back up, open the graph, select more measurements, and now instead of an S parameter, I'm going to go look for noise figure, which is NF here. We'll click on that, press OK, and because the two measurements, y-axes would be wildly different, what we're going to do is display it on the other y-axis here. I'll press OK, and here we have simultaneously both the gain and noise figure displayed. One additional item here, you see as I press the vertices button that the graph loses or displays the actual data points. Let's add another graph here, and this we'll be interested in oftentimes for active devices, is K, or stability. So I'll select stability factor, press OK, and then notice K is going to be displayed. We press OK again, and here's the stability factor for our device, and we're going to tile this so we can see all of them simultaneously. And one more measurement I'd like to add to this is G-op, that is, what is the optimum gamma for noise match. Again, we go back to our measurements wizard, and we select G-opt, OK, and then press OK, and there it's displayed in green, as you see. Oftentimes, we'd like to view and use unilateral gain circles. So here we set up another graph. I'll double-click on that. We'll change the format to Smith, and we'll edit the measurement and more measurements, and we'll select unilateral gain for input port, and here we'll manually select GU2 for the output port. And here we see the centers of both displayed here on a Smith chart. If I click on a frequency, here you see the concentric circles, gain circles, for both input and output. What I'd like to show you now is how we can add to our workspace, and in this case we'll add another schematic. We go down to Designs, Add Schematic, and in this case I'm going to name it Match, M-A-T-C-H. And there you see a blank schematic. I'll reposition that, zoom in a little bit on it. And what I'm going to do is put down a couple of lump components. I'll press the L key for inductor, and I'll make two of those in series. Then I'll use the C key as a hot key to generate a capacitor. And you notice I'm dragging these vertically. Then I'm going to use the G key to add a ground. And then we're going to place ports on this component, or circuit. I for input, O for output. And then we want to add values to this. So we double-click on the component. And in this case, I'm going to add 17 nanohenries. Press OK. And there's our first element. Okay, so I took a shortcut and actually added the rest of the component values, as you see here. Now, what I'll do now is add another analysis for this particular schematic. It's called Linear 2, and we'll leave it default names. Instead of Schematic 1, we're going to have Design Match 2 that will be simulated. We'll leave the rest of the values as default. And just to ensure that we did have a simulation, we'll right-click on the output node, and there we go. We can generate a graph of S21 of that particular circuit. Now, we can reuse this network if you want. We can select all of them like I'm doing here and do a copy and paste into a second schematic. That's one way of reusing the schematic. A second way, maybe a little more elegant, than I'll show you here, is first of all, I'm using the Alt key to help separate my port from my device. I select the components, linear components, and here you see I'm selecting a data set, a two-port data set element, and drop that on a schematic. And I'll attach that to my device as well as the output port. And now let's double click on that box. And we'll go to the advanced options, and you'll notice that I have multiple selections for which kind of models I want to use. I can use another data set. In this case, I'm going to use the subnetwork which we created called Match. And now that box points towards that LC combination that we had just developed. So now I'll do a simulation of that combined network. And then here we see on the Smith chart, the output actually shows a better match for S22 over the range that we're using the device over. So it really was our output matching network. Let me show you some other ways that we can utilize the linear parameters. If we double click on the data set, which are the green boxes, and here I select S, right click on that, and now I can export my S parameter, my measured S parameter for that set, to another data set if we wish. It's just that simple. So I hope I showed you in these last few minutes how easy it is to use linear simulation in Genesys. Thank you.